Good day, everyone. It's Jill with Astro Press. I'm going to talk about the astrological energy next week, starting Sunday, Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. The moon's in Virgo. Ask your mom what you can do to help her. It's really simple to work with the energy that day. So it will go, the energy I'm going to discuss goes from Sunday, the 12th, all the way to the end of the week, which is the 18th, when we end on a full intense moon in Scorpio. So how you can use this energy is by the energetic aspects and working with it in your own life. You don't have to know anything, really, even about astrology. But if you are a sun sign of Taurus or a rising sign of Taurus or Cancer or Scorpio, the energy focus is more about you this week. And so, as well, if you know your natal chart, those of you who aren't Tauruses or Cancers or Scorpios, no worries. As long as you know what houses these energies rule, you will know where it's going to play out in your own life and what your focus might be or how you want to utilize these energies. So when we jump on over to Wednesday, May 15th, we've got Venus, the planet that rules Taurus, the planet of love and beauty and material things and beautiful artwork and beautiful paintings and creativeness. And it's like being out in a field of flowers, just enjoying the sensuality of the smell and the colors of all those flowers and the feel of those flowers and the textures and the just all that earthy, just awesomeness of sensuality. And so for Taurus, this week you still have the sun shining in Taurus and Mercury is still in Taurus, which is all about communications. Add Venus in Taurus, which will be there until June 8th, and you got a lot of energy to work with. And so when you talk about Venus, are you looking for love, Taurus? Well, put yourself out there. Maybe love will come to you. Maybe you'll meet a lover. Are you looking to get more money, Taurus? Maybe it's a good time to ask your boss for that raise. Maybe you need to check your financial statements. Find out, hey, are you owed money? Because money could come at this time based on the energy. So there's a heavy energy of Taurus. Then also, same day, Wednesday, Mars goes into Cancer. Mars is all about action. So in general, you can use this energy to remodel your home, to move, to talk to your family, to go somewhere with your family, to have conversations with your family, to make the first move with your family. Have you not spoken to your family for a while? Was there some disagreements or arguing with your family? Maybe now's the time to take the action. Make the first step. Even if your family members could be stubborn, take the first step and initiate with them. Now, it can also mean that there's still some challenges with the family. It's also a sexual energy, Mars. It's also about the body and physicality and being a gym rat and being exercise oriented and just looking amazing and making a great first impression. Cancer, sun signs, and rising signs, make your first impressions now. The energy is working in your favor up until July 1st, 2019. Now, Cancer, the only thing you need to be mindful of is your ruler, which is Mother Moon. She gets bored easily, right? And she changes signs every 2.5 days. And that energy you feel because you're emotional, you're sensitive, and you can pick up on it. So if you're feeling up and down about your behaviors around getting things done or taking action, just know it is that moon energy affecting you. So either push through it or just say, okay, I'm going to chill today. Now let's end the week with that Scorpio full moon. And if you have any residue left over from any toxic relationships, from anything that has gone wrong in your life, from anything that you can't get out of your energy field. You know, sometimes there's relationships that are done, but you can still feel those energies in your energy field. It's like the remnants are there. You know, this is a good energy to work on releasing those energies to the moon. Write them down, what you don't want. Let it go. Let it go. With Scorpio being the most intense, passionate water sign and very, very secretive and very, very powerful and very much about endings, transformation, letting things go. You have all this full moon energy with Scorpio, and it's like a double letting go energy. So if there's anybody that in your family may be not feeling well, don't be surprised if you hear of people passing, making their transition. This is a letting go energy. And so make those calls to anybody you know who may not be feeling so good. Maybe someone you haven't talked to in a while. Don't have regrets. Okay? Make sure you make those phone calls. Now, if you're in an energy where you feel like the person is kind of attached, you can do cord cutting as well. Cord cutting is very effective to do. You can Google cord cutting and find out more, but I highly recommend cord cutting because sometimes the truth is we are attached to people's energy, not because we want to be. It's just because that's how it is. So release what no longer works, and be mindful and be in touch with people that you think might transition, because they could during this energy. So Scorpio sun and rising signs, this is very intense energy you're going to have on you, but you are used to intensity. You know this intensity. So that's what we've got going for the week of the 12th of May to the 18th of May. I wish everyone well, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye. A really good marker for athleticism in the career when Aries is at the top. So let's say you are trying to get on a specific team, football team, baseball. Now's the time. Go out and do your thing, so to speak. Be seen. Also, wherever it falls in any of the houses, that's where you're going to feel it. So look to where it falls in one of your houses or the angles or which planet is it falling on. Is it falling on the sun? Is it falling on the moon? Rising sign, Mercury, Venus, Mars. If you were born with Venus in Aries, you're going to have a Venus return. So it's going to be an extra emphasis there. Every year, we normally all have a Venus return because it takes Venus 30 days, about 30 days. Don't quote me on that. To travel to each sign. Now, when she's retrograde, it's a whole different story. But That's the story about Venus in Aries right now. Enjoy this wonderful transit of Venus in Aries. I'll talk to you soon.